Hello, everybody. My name is Ray. Welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. I'm here with Rainbow,
who just woke up, and he hasn't gone to sleep yet. So, should be fun.
Oh, yeah. where we last left off, those guys just dropped in. I decided to go ahead and kill them, save some time. Now there's a bunch of data points that we have to listen to throughout here. So,
let's get with it.
Yeah, prepare to sit here and listen to everything.
With Suzanne Alpert, environmental scientist. Doctor?
I'm sorry, I wasn't,
Just stating your name. What were you thinking about, Doctor?
Nothing the General said, not really. I was on the Syzygy East Response Team in 2051, just after the second earthquake compromised the reactor. I still dream about it, after all these years. The red zone spreading on the imaging, slowly, so slowly, like a hand opening its fingers.
Your involvement in that event is why you were asked for by name.
Really? That's interesting. Because nothing worked. Nothing could grow there again. It was a catastrophic failure. But the red zone is a blip compared to global scale biomass reduction. The biosphere and hydrosphere will collapse, render the Earth uninhabitable long before the robots finish us. Enduring victory can't buy time against that. So, you'd better show me what Zero Dawn really is.
She knows what's up. Alright, there's that. Oh god, no, I don't want to read through all that. Because I don't want to sit here for an hour listening and reading, so if y'all want to read it, you can pause and read that. I don't want to waste that time.
Yeah, I kind of don't either.
I'm sure you
exactly.
Now understand the urgency of why we brought
usually
you here.
Usually I do, but not this time.
Captain Okilo, are you trying to thank me for not resisting?
I believe we couldn't negotiate a diplomatic solution.
When it came to my country's lithium, it was always a swarm that would be sent to negotiate. Metallurgic International, U.S. Robot Command. The markings changed, but the robots were the same.
You have had considerable experience in human-robot conflict.
Yes, and I've got the prosthetic limbs to show it. Yet I continue to face this horror, even though the challenge was great. Cyber warfare. I thought Zero Dawn would be a Manhattan project to generate the deactivation codes. With the resources I had, I estimated code-breaking to be a hopeless endeavor. I was almost looking forward to being proved wrong.
Unfortunately, your estimation was correct.
As your General Hera said. So then, you did not bring me here to commiserate. What is left?
Look, let's cut the mystery. You're building a colony ship. It's obvious. And it's not gonna fly. I mean, literally. Remember the Odyssey? That multinational heap of space junk that's been in graveyard orbit since 57? That went nowhere real slow, and you have to get somewhere real fast. Do you have any idea the immensity of the challenge to prep a new colony ship in time?
To be clear, I'm not a worker on the project.
Do you even understand how few people it could save? The whole generation ship concept is not gonna happen. It's the first thing you'd abandon in favor of embryonics. For that kind of storage we're talking, a lot of bulk, a lot of power, a lot of resources. So even if you do it, even if you build it and point it at Sirius X, there's no room for people on that thing, all right?
If you could try to remain calm.
You people are crazy if you think you're getting off this rock. No one's getting off.
Medical.
His voice sounds familiar. Like, he was a voice in something we watched.
You
already
listened to those?
Huh? To these, yeah. Almost to these.
It is accurate, yes.
So these mechanical monstrosities, they don't just kill people. They feed off them?
Not just people. All organic matter.
Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Millennia of evolution liquefied. The miracle of life reduced to bloody biofuel.
In a word, yes.
Who did this? Pharaoh? That asshole. Is he here? No, Doctor. Please, tell him Tom Pike wants a word. Now, get off! Get off! Doctor, please! You get Ted Pharaoh in here!
Shit. Oh.
Well. Oh, lovely.
Want to discuss? Oof.
So, Mama, she was right.
Pardon?
My mother, she took her Bible real serious. Not just Texas Bubble serious, Pentecostal serious. Favorite chapter? Revelations. Now, I didn't always understand her on account of all that speaking in tongues and such, but when she did use her words, it was always end times this and the lake of fire that on account of sinful lifestyles. Speaking of which, mind if I smoke?
A tobacco cigarette.
Sorry, darling. My taste run classic. Compliments to your team tracked me down. Been a price on my head 18 months now. Sterling Malky was me, don't mind admitting. Been plenty of snakesters chasing the bounty, too. But I kept the zigging to their zag. How'd you finger me?
I believe Dr. Sobeck listed you as an alpha candidate. Priority snatch and grab.
Always suspected she had a little thing for me. Hey, I don't suppose you got real coffee in this place. You know, blood coffee, conflict cappuccinos.
Mr. Tate, I'm clearing you to proceed. Just go.
Jeez, I'm done with him. Oh, crap.
Jesus.
You previously worked for Pharaoh Automated Systems.
On the chariot line self-replication routines? I came here thinking this was a rendition. When your people took me, I thought, about time. I've been trying to swallow the guilt every day since...
Would you like to take a moment?
No, I just... I really hoped Zero Dawn was a way to undo it all. My work. And I'm sorry to say I was ever proud of it, but... Ted could really sell a concept, and in the labs, in the light of creation, that first test run, when you saw they understood their own structures, could rebuild themselves from memory and light, there were no limits. God, there were no limits.
Rebuild themselves from light. That is fascinating.
Shit, dude. Ted fucked up hardcore.
Oh, Ted fucked really hardcore.
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth what? Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the reflourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it.
Aloy is one of those embryos.
We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
That is brilliant.
Oh my god.
The whole Earth destroyed, but then remade?
Yes. By a machine. A machine of creation.
Elizabeth did this. For life. For us. But why Hades then? If it was part of Gaia, how'd it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot? And why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
We need to talk about this for a minute.
What if Hades took the knowledge to breed a stupid and ignorant new generation of people to feed off of?
To enslave. So the coding of Hades was corrupt. Somehow became corrupt and decided to start taking over everything. Hephaestus was the entity that I mentioned going through the cauldrons, reprogramming the machine creations to make them deadly and to make them more numerous.
That was not what I was expecting as Elizabeth's solution. I understand why it's a war crime, because it meant literally just letting the Earth get devoured. Letting people die.
And then rebuilding it.
And then rebuilding it. Like, we can't save this, so let's start over.
I mean, at this point, nothing is really a war crime, though, because the world's going to end, so everything's...
True.
Oh my god.
That is very impressive. Like, you know, Pharaoh created his own fuck up, and Elizabeth's, well, I'll create a solution similar to your fuck up, but better.
Well, they didn't really stop the ultimate fuck up. They just let it run its course, like you said, and then just reboot with a perfect system, except it somehow became not perfect.
And I'm thinking that the initial corruption that was in Pharaoh's machines made its way into Gaia or something like that. Something along those lines had to have happened.
One of the scientists who was working on it was part of Pharaoh's robot team. But that's too obvious.
Yeah, that's too obvious.
Well, let's keep going.
Kind of like the ultimate battle of good versus evil. They're both sentient AIs. One to create and one that wants to destroy. So it's kind of like...
Make your selection. What? You'll be assigned sub-project team based on your area of expertise. Upon successful completion, meet family or two persons choosing will be transferred to the asylum's sealed habitat to live out the remainder of your natural lives. Indefinite detention, which means you'll just be locked up forevermore since you know way too much. Medical euthanasia, which means you'll be put into a medical induced and come in and just die. Huh. Three different choices that they give you. Neat. Fascinating. Oh my god.
Ted fucked up so hard. Like, I think that is the... God. I can't even comprehend how monumental a screw-up that is.
Nothing important in there. Same basic routine shit that we've been hearing this whole time. Are you a voice recording? Yes.
Of course I'll do it. To be given the opportunity to rebuild what I... the damage that I... Well, I don't feel worthy of it, but I will do it, absolutely.
I want to stress that this was never about your culpability.
It is to me. Dr. Sobek, Margot, they were smart to get out of Pharaoh when they did, but not one of us took it as a warning sign. It just told ourselves they weren't cut out for the BTRI cabals. That's the better than rapid innovation. A better at competing, better than the next guy, a better killing machine. I think it's just amazing how since 2.5 of science fiction did nothing to swerve our species from the path of doom. I mean, I'm done with that life. I mean, I will work hard, twice as hard, to earn this, for my family to have a place in Elysium. I never thought that there could be atonement.
Yeah, this time hold still while it plays so you don't trigger something else.
Yeah, seriously.
If you're still nauseous. No, the inhibitors have kicked in. I can't feel the back of my tongue. I wish I could tell you I'd believe in this. But the damage is too great, too extensive, too complete. With all respect to Dr. Sobek's work at Miriam, no. No, life doesn't always find a way to keep going. Sometimes it never comes back. Like Syzygy East. Like the Congo. Like Timo. Like us. That's our reward? A buried city full of terminal patients waiting out the clock? You grow old together, with your loved ones, in safety. I don't have loved ones. I suppose I could start a family? I'm afraid not. All inhabitants of Elysium will be medically sterilized. A habitat capable of sustaining a starting base of 2,000 individuals for up to 100 years is a huge challenge, Dr. Alpert. If the population grows instead of diminishes, everyone will be dead inside 30 years. I knew it. I just couldn't bring myself to say the words. I'm sorry. Finish it. Medical euthanasia. I want no part of this. I just want it over. I see. Protocols require a 48-hour waiting period, after which...
Alright, so then these are all the part two interviews after they've received all this news. Oh, I'm still blown away.
I am too. Like, I never could have imagined that that would be her solution.
Shackles. What? Huh. Weird. Okay. I've yet to see anyone asking for those.
Alrighty then.
Yeah. I've never seen people asking for those. Maybe it's a later on thing. Oh, gotta crouch. What does this do? Hmm. Okay, nothing here. Oh, wow.
So, Aloy literally was born from All-Mother.
Oh, shit. Yeah, she was.
Huh. Which means crazy, what, matriarchs? What were they called? It's been a while since we've been back there.
Yeah.
Crazy ones, yeah. Crazy matriarch lady was right. I mean, Elizabeth Sobeck is still technically her mother, but she was born from in there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Hold on. I need to see something. Ooh. I'll be right back. I just remembered. Oh, shit. Fucking. Duh. This. These. I never checked these out. Through these. If there's nothing important, whatever, we'll just go back to where I was. There's gotta be something down through here, otherwise they wouldn't. Oh, are these really just like sneak arounds to get around those people? Are you kidding me? There's nothing in here.
That's what it looks like.
Ah. Hold on, there's one. Over here, though. Let's. Ah. Damn it. Okay, well, I just thought about this. I was hoping there was something down there. Excuse me. Never mind. We'll just cut back into where I was then. Sorry for wasting your time on that. I know you're just as excited as I am.
Oh, dude, you know what? That means they were right about All-Mother, too. Mm. She really is All-Mother. She gave life to everything.
Mm-hmm.
Son of a bitch.
Which means we kind of need to apologize in a way, because in a way they are right. But we were right, too.
We were right. It's not just some superstitious.
So that in a way we're thing. Both
it's,
right.
It's legitimate.
Yeah. So that we're both right.
Yep.
Ha-ha.
Intruder! Neat. Get her!
Spanish.
Whatever you do, don't die now.
Wow, they just came out of nowhere. Okay. I would appreciate it if you couldn't do that, please. That would be nice. That was just kind of mean. Crap. Oh, hey. You know, I'll come back for you. I'm kind of busy right now, trying not to die. Level 60. Oh, God. These are big guys. Okay.
Yeah.
Really? Like, I've got plenty of healing, so it's fine. It's just a hindrance, really. You're about to die, so it doesn't really matter to me.
What?
What? The fuck was... Okay. Oh, well, I don't even know what the hell she just did there.
She literally popped around the corner and went, look what I can do!
How about that what I can do?
Firing the less powerful arrows.
Please just die already. Thank you.
Like I said, those were my less powerful ones because I didn't want to have to waste 100 of these things to kill that one dude. Because these take up more resources to make, so... That was on me. I'm now using corruption arrows somehow. Okay, whatever. There. You're corrupted. Can I now use these? That would be nice. No, I don't need to. Oh, they're attacking each other. It would be nice if they would kill each other now. That would
face
be
the sun's judgment.
Fantastic. All right. Thank you.
Is there another route?
I've done this before. Just need my focus.
Okay, that was... Okay, we're gonna go back and listen to that data point real quick. No, not you. Damn it.
You still need to grab that, though.
Grab what?
Medicine.
Oh. Yeah, thank you.
I hashed it out with them. What the point of Artemis was. I made it clear I wasn't on board for a global zoo. We haven't exactly proved ourselves to be great custodians in the past few thousand years. So the idea of a reconstituted biosphere... Well, it's horrifying, isn't it? A complete horror show. We have no right to take a best guess at this stuff. But the alternative? Nothingness. For there to have been all this, and then... nothing. And with Charles Ronson running the show, I respect him. He's got a passion to him. He's hot-blooded. So I said I'll do it. I'll put my all into this, literally. When the project is done, I'll take the medical option, thank you. The counselor said I might change my mind. I told him that he didn't know me very well then. For life's sake, I'll do the dirty work. But I want no part of this pathetic, attenuated future on offer. I'm an outdoors man. Never did like the feel of solid-state lighting on my skin. And... a wee bit of a claustrophobe, anyway.
Alright, then.
I can respect that.
I can, too.
Zero Dawn. It is art, in a way. An expression on the grandest scale. But there is so much unfairness. Why was I chosen? Was it decided by committee? By algorithm? My family will be saved because I happen to graduate in art history? Is this right?
Dr. Souvey? Christina Souvey?
Yes. I met a man, another historian. His fields are Bauhaus and the New Materialists. But he once attended one of my talks. Another unfair chance. Of all the many people in their auditorium, that we should both be here now. And yet, I feel more accepting of my fate. No, it is not fair, not at all. But for the sake of my family, for the sake of art. Art is alive. It must be able to speak from beyond history and echo in the future, not perish into oblivion. This opportunity, I must do this.
Haha, that's where you're wrong, because guess what happens?
Yeah, someone took it.
Right.
Now, those lame FBI black hats at Mockingbird back in the day, I enjoyed schooling them. But maybe I went in too hard on this poor counselor. She was cute, and just going down a checklist after all. Couldn't expect her to see how ridiculous Zero D's ambitions are. God's own budget thrown at a kid playing with a hologram sculptor? Palms up, honey. I'm just calling it like it is. Hey, look, Mom, I'm making nature. Now, if nature is so important, why not let nature take its course?
Look at me,
Ma! Extinction? That's natural.
That's funny.
Zero Dawn? Like, oh, ma'am, that ain't. Heck, it's so unnatural it'd be called an abomination back home, and you know it. That's why you're hiding it. Meanwhile, my little honey of a counselor, she's munching the inside of her cheek. Bad habit. She chewed one of her nails, too, just one. Not your day, was it, little sweet pea? Saw her quota slipping away. Said, I assume you intend to decline the assignment, Mr. Tate. You kidding me? 18 months hard labor in exchange for 30 years lounging around Elysium watching porn? Sign me up.
Okay, so then he changed his mind.
Well then, alright.
All because of that little counselor.
Neat.
I kind of like him. It's okay.
Well, he talks about his mom being super religious, and this goes against religion, so I think that may have had a part to play in it, just a little bit.
That's why he likes it so much. He's like, hey, this goes against everything I was brought up in. Perfect.
Stocking
Let's
up.
Do it.
Alright.
It is, if you notice, he doesn't seem to be the moral type.
No, I think he's the furthest thing from it.
True.
All right, we'll continue this in the next episode, guys. Bye.
Bye.